guys, welcome back to Death and Stranding Outdoors. There's like a set pine needles in a dirt hole. That's what I caught a raccoon in the other day. We're just checking the line. This is also the coyote line. I just set these though before the snow. And then there we got basically it's a hill or bale of hay that's been just set there. And I got like a hay set built into the bottom of it. So, then we got a couple up here. It's cold out. It hasn't snowed since yesterday morning, and it's still on the ground. I got a DP stuck into there. That stump. To the camera, I'm trying to steer. This thing's hard to steer when it's sideways. Yeah, nothing here. I basically got a log there. It's covered in snow, the trap. A log with urine on it, walk by. I'm gonna set you down. I gotta put my glove on, guys. I can't feel my hand. I'm gonna try to edit this into the other part when I'm up the road, so. You can go through the cornfield. I got two more sets over here, and then I got some across the road. So. There's a deer right next to me. There's always deer up here, guys. I tell you what, if you want a deer hunt, come to PA. There's so many deer in PA, guys. It's unbelievable. It's crazy. They're right down here around the corner, so not that far. I set a new one here last night because the one, there was a deer track on my trap and a coyote track, and the dirt was kind of like pushed off of it. Not where they actually did it, it was on accident from their paw print, so they didn't smell my trap, which is good. Pine trees, and it's scary and dark though, I'll tell you that. There's so many bear down here, it's unbelievable. So I'm not seeing anything in the post set. I believe the dirt hole's over here. Let me try to find it. It's really blended in, guys. Know is that if I catch something, no, it's over here. Nothing there. The dirt's kind of like froze up. I will get one here though, because the coyotes that walk through this little path here are unbelievable. That's the set that just that and the post. Alright, I'll see you when I get over to the other two on the other side. Hey guys, I'm back. Takes a while to get over here. I might pull these tomorrow. But, up here... around this bend... got a dirt hole right over here. Right there, it's a triple dirt hole with a mound of grass. Nothing there, and then I got a DP up here to make this worthwhile, so. I got stuff to make coonpait yesterday, so I'm gonna try to edit this video into the other parts, which will come on. Well, first, there's nothing in the trap. I'm not seeing them. That's weird. Someone took the trap. Someone took it. So. Alright. Well, I'll find who did it. And I'll get it from them. So. Alright. I'll see you up the road, and that'll be right about now. You guys, welcome back. We're up the road. And pocket set has nothing in it. I'm not expecting anything out of that pocket set for a while, because the water's kind of low and it's freezing out and there's ice on the water, so I'm not really expecting anything. I think this would be part 7 to the series. So, oh, what's that? Hey, looky here. Got some dog prints. And they're walking my trail. Those are fox. Those are either fox or coyote. Yep, they're walking on my trail, which is a good sign. Okay, so I checked the weasel box. I love weasel trapping. It's so fun. Even if I don't catch anything. Nothing. I really enjoy weasel trapping, so. There's nothing in there. I will get one this year, at least one. That's my goal. They are harder to get in PA, but when you get them, it's really cool. And those fox tracks are going all the way up here. There's nothing in the stick set. Oh man, these tracks are going right up through here. Oh, they're going right up. Something went through here. He never checked this set out. And then there's no paw prints here. And I think he stopped back there. He started walking sideways, so. Something's been lurking around here, guys. It's annoying seeing tracks like that, and they stop right before you get to your sets. It's so annoying. They just, oh. There we go. Right on the trap bed. They missed the trap. The best thing for that, I'm leaving it. I'm leaving it just like that. Look at those tracks. So he didn't smell anything. He just. I'm happy with that. I'm really happy with that. Maybe he'll come back through and check those, you know? They do that sometimes. He's walking up here too. I can see the tracks. That'd be funny if he went to every freaking set. The thing is, all the sets right now, they're frozen in. Even with peat moss, they're frozen. So I would have caught him. It's just everything's frozen right now. So those, honestly, to me, I think those were fox tracks. Like, yeah, he didn't come up here. He didn't come up here. Wow, that's something. Seeing something you've never caught, the tracks of it right around your trap, and it just doesn't go off. I'll get him. I'll get him this year, don't worry. I think he went into that trail that was there, right by my set. I think he come out of that trail. Nothing there, no tracks. Okay, so he stopped. He stopped over on the side of the field, so we're good. Nothing in that hay set. Wonder if there's paw prints on this set. So he went to that dirt hole. Nothing there. He went to that dirt hole then, guys. He went straight to that dirt hole. Let's go inspect. I'd like to see where he come out of. Because those are fox tracks. Right around my sets, too. I'm not even going to rebait them. I'm just going to leave them. It's the best thing to do. Because if he's not trap shy like that, you know, maybe it's best just to leave it. Nothing in the weasel box. Alright, so thanks for watching NG Outdoors, and you know what? We're going to catch him. So you just wait. Alright, bye.